Did you see this story, this Martha Rosenberg story? It was an alternate. Yep. How Big Pharma Brainwashes Americans into Believing They're Sick. This struck me because when I read it, I was in deposition, taking deposition in a case called Pradaxa, which is a drug. It's a blood thinner that's killing people. You take it because you have atrial fib problems. It's like Coumadin. It's supposed to, you know, thin your blood. Only Coumadin doesn't kill you. You have an antidote if your blood becomes too thin, you can use it and it can stop the bleeding for Coumadin. This is a product, if you can believe it, Sam. This is a product that's out there that causes your blood to thin, and when you start bleeding to death in the emergency room because you're involved in a minor accident, there's no antidote to stop it. The only one of them out there that's like that, but it's still on the market. Now, this article by Martha Rosenberg was talking about how Big Pharma brainwashes Americans into believing they need a product. This was a perfect example. You've had a drug out there for 60 years that is the gold standard for treating the very problem that Pradaxa was out there supposed to be treating. You know, Pradaxa is supposed to thin blood. Well, Coumadin thins blood too. Only when you start bleeding to death with Coumadin, you take vitamin K and it stops the bleeding. Here, we have case after case after case of somebody going into the emergency room on things like they fell down, they bruised their head, and they bleed to death in the emergency room. Their brain fills up with blood. Now, I asked the guy, why did you even put this product on the market? It wasn't necessary. You didn't need it. It didn't serve any purpose where there wasn't something already out there. And when you drilled down and looked at the documents, it was completely, utterly, without exception, about making money.
Right.
And so you have an industry now that uses this thing called unbranded advertising, where they go out and they scare the hell out of the American public with these insidious kind of advertising, telling them that they need this drug that's a new drug instead of the old drug, or they have a disease that they haven't even thought about because they invented the friggin' disease. And we see it, for example, the New York Times just did an article on T-cell, you know, on testosterone. And they said, well, what happened was the industry went out, the people that are selling this testosterone gel and testosterone, deodorant, they actually went out and scared the hell out of men in saying, you're suffering from this new disease. And then they come onto the market and they start selling testosterone. This unbranded marketing is killing us. It's telling us that we're sad because of some ridiculous reason. And if we take their pill, they're going to be better. No epidemiology shows it. No clinicals really show it, but they sell it anyway. We have a pharmaceutical industry, Sam, that has gone completely crazy. And the FDA is crazy right along with them and refuses to do anything about it as far as stopping this mass murder. That's what's taking place here, is mass murder. This Pradaxa drug, Sam, people are dying. We're dying by the hundreds, bleeding to death over things like stubbing their friggin' toe and the toenail starts bleeding and they can't stop the bleeding. And the people bleed to death in the emergency room. But that's what the industry is up to, and there's nobody right now in America that is stopping this. Nobody.
That's right. I mean, I don't think that the American public is aware just how lax, in some respects, the FDA rules are governing this stuff. A company does not have to prove that this is that they put a drug on the market that it's actually going to help anything. They just got to put it out there, and then essentially create the market by telling Americans that they're sick.
Making it up, inventing it out of the air. And you know what? Here's what they know, Sam. Once they get the drug on the market, it is virtually impossible for the FDA to get the drug off the market, because the FDA is owned, operated completely by the industry today as we sit here. You know what? Obama administration has done zero to change any of that. The FDA has become actually worse over the last 6 years under this president.